get right to be able to choke someone safely. So the choke is really essential. Obviously, once you've broken the guy's posture, and we're looking at a standing choke, is that you run the hand down the artery as tight as you can. Here is that by breaking his posture, notice how I broke his posture down, is that I wrap the arm, forearm around, making sure that the point of the elbow is in line with his chin. I don't want to be like this because this is on his windpipe. What I want to do is close one artery and close squeeze the other artery. Squeeze and I pull up, gently, he'll feel the pressure on both his carotid arteries, which leads to him blacking or passing out. If you hide your hand, just repeat the point, it's really difficult for him, essentially, from here, to escape, because my head is blocking the hand that he needs to pull off to defend. However, he manages to get it off, I can still open, swing around to the other side, and apply the choke on the other side. So there's a game of cat and mouse where we can keep that going. So it's very difficult for him to actually escape once it's locked in. Hopefully you've enjoyed this. Keep watching for some more of our videos. Thanks for watching.